वैसे ही रख दो, वैसे ही मत, ज्यादा परेशान मत हो। हेलो, हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। ओके, सो लेट्स वेट फॉर 1 or 2 मिनट्स मोर सो दैट अदर्स कैन ज्वाइन। ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आई होप यू कैन हियर मी।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके, सो आई बिलीव वी कैन गेट स्टार्टेड एंड अदर्स विल ज्वाइन इन द मीन वाइल। सो अगेन, सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग द क्लास इट इन अ वेरी चिली वेदर। And I believe it's too early for many of you, but yeah, I mean, this is how it has been scheduled in this semester. So let's get started. Okay, so let me share my screen. So I hope you can see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So thank you everyone for writing down all your group member details here. So please try this. So try completing this as early as possible, because the early you finish this task, you will have more time to discuss with your partners to finalize the different topics, projects that you want to do. So as many of you have requested for some sample projects, so we have listed down a number of projects. So some of them from, last year IR class, from Professor Tanmay, and some of them are from other well-known positions like UIUC and others. As I said, these are you are not constrained to these projects. You are free to choose any other topics. Probably I will be going into more details for the project discussion today, because many of you have requested could we get more insight, and even in the last class we have discussed a lot of details. So I just try to formalize in the slide so that we are on the same pace, and you also understand what we are going to do in the project. Okay, so regarding looking at the partners, so I believe now it's very easy, right? At least simply look at the people who are looking for project partners and you can form a group, right? So for example, Prashant, Risha, Batul, Kriti, and Yatish, right? I mean, you five can make a group. I believe if you five people are looking for this, you simply can form the group, right? Similarly, others who are still looking for project partners, please write your name here. And in this way, basically, we can simply form a group for you as well, and you can find the project partners. Okay, since there is a lot of gap, I am not able to see how many people have formed the group, but on average, close to 36 groups have been formed. And I expect probably there will be probably at least 10 more groups should be there, hopefully. So regarding the project's group size, many of you have asked me, probably these or many others. So what if, we want to form a group with two members? I reply to them email as well, but for your reference, I am perfectly fine if you want to make a group of two. Some of you have mentioned the reasons so that you can have good learning, you have to do more. I mean, I'm perfectly fine. That is good, actually. It is up to you. But I just want to reiterate what I asked and told in the last class. Either you work in a group of two, three, four, or five. I mean, we are going to evaluate the final outcome and the final, what is the final outcome of your project, irrespective of whether it's done by two, three, or four. So you should not come to us and say, sir, I mean, we are only two people in the project, so please be lenient and so on, right? So that will not be the case, at least here. So you still have time if you want to add, I mean, more people in the group. It is your choice. I mean, I understand many people not very much comfortable in the big group, so that's their choice. So is it clear? Any questions here on the project group formation or looking for partners or sample projects? Anyone? Okay, so I believe everything is in order. So another thing, as I told you, we are planning to schedule 1 hour, you may call it any name, either you call it doubt clearing session, you may call it tutorial, you may call it, questions, whatever you have, or you can say office hours or so. So different TAs will be have allocated one hour of their time. So 1 to 2 p.m. So I believe there is no class between 1 to 2 p.m. So you'll have to... So in fact, the thing is, I requested them to keep a time of 5:30 to 6:30 so that it don't clash with your existing timetable, right? But some of them have mentioned other timing. So I will assign the group to them. So if you are not available, if you're not available due to time clash or something, so let the TAs know. They will probably come up with some other time slot. Ideally, I mean, whatever the groups will be assigned to different TAs, it shouldn't clash with the neither your or probably the TA's time, so that at least we are fixing 1 hour weekly slot for any doubts you have, you want to discuss. So one more thing, I mean, so these TAs who will be assigned to different groups, and in a group there will be five to six groups, so consisting of, you can say, in total 25 to 30 students, right? So 20 to 25 students. So in that case, these TAs will be your immediate mentor, as well as immediate contact point of contact for discussing any questions that you have on the projects. And definitely, I will be also available whenever you want me to discuss. I will be available. We can fix some time. And if there is a lot of requirement, I will also set up an office hour for meeting with myself, and you can come anytime and set up a discussion that you want to. Right. So in this way, I mean, each TA will be helping you. I will share this sheet soon, and we'll see. I mean, we'll see if it is possible to start from this week itself, or if not, then certainly from next week onwards, we are going to start this. Okay. So this is regarding the kind of tutorial or mentoring session. One thing I also wanted to ask, can you people raise hand? Do you want any introductory 1 hour or 2 hour session on natural language processing? Please raise your hand, those in it.
Yes, sir.
Just raise your hand. Sir. Please raise your hand. Yeah. So it seems I can see a good number of people are asking for that. What we will do, we'll set up a 1 hour. 1 hour or 2 hour session with, of course, we cannot cover whole natural language processing course because that is something not feasible, but definitely we will set up a one hour session so that it can provide you, at least direct you the different resources, right? It can direct you to different resources and at least provide you some fundamentals of natural language processing. And so that basically that will be helpful to you in this project. So, given the number of hands, I hope, we should definitely do this. So we'll try to set up again. So this session will not be mandatory for everyone. it is only based on your requirement basis, right? So if you want, you are free to attend. But definitely, I mean, those who are committing to attend this, we expect them to commit this, attend this, and we'll share Google form soon so that we know who are the people interested to attend this, and we'll be following if they are indeed attending this or not. We'll try to set up this again in the not office hours so that it won't clash with your timetable, and hopefully that should be helpful to you. Another session I wanted to ask regarding, again, so all of you probably may have studied machine learning or something. So how many of you want a 1 or 2 hour session on, I mean, you're already aware of fundamentals of machine learning. So more on, I would say, the how you can basically use any existing models to run, how you can do hyperparameter tuning and so on. So please raise your hand again. So those don't want this session, they can unraise their hand. So please raise your hand again who want a session of 1 or 2 hours on how to use different machine learning models, how to use, how to perform the hyperparameter tuning and so on.
Sir, actually we are from Enterbatch also. So, and we have taken machine learning course and we have just started learning machine learning. So it will be convenient for us to join this also.
Sorry, which machine learning course you're talking about?
Sir, in the winter season, which Saket sir is...
No, so that I cannot say anything, right? And that you'll have to check with him. I cannot say anything.
No. I am saying we have just started learning this.
Okay. So you're already taking that course
for us also, yeah. Is it possible for us?
Okay, good. So in that case, I mean, whatever we are offering, maybe augment your knowledge. Again, it is more on a voluntary basis. We don't want to force anyone to attend this. So what I will do, I will share Google form and just let just get the information who want to attend the session. And even though there will be just 10 people out of 10 or 20 people out of a whole class, 200 plus students, I will be very happy to conduct the session because I want to help everyone in the class. Okay, so that's regarding the survey and the tutorial. Any questions here? Anyone? Okay, how are you doing today? I mean, I cannot see that energy that I saw in last semester, last class. Did you had a cup of tea or something? So please have it. Okay, cool. So let's get started with the more detailed project presentation, project details. Okay. So I have tried to basically formalize and probably write down all the details of project. So that will basically help you to refer to this document, and I will further augment this, further write down this in the coming week and so. So the aim of the project is kind of very clear, I hope. Thus, the course project is to give the student hands-on experience on solving some novel IR or data mining related problems. So as I said, that's why we have given you some of the sample projects somehow related with these two or related topics. So either you can choose from them, or you can choose any papers or probably any papers from the previously published conferences, top conferences like CIGAR, ICMR, and so on. So as I mentioned in the last class, so the project does emphasize either on research-oriented problems or engineering problems, right? So if you recall, I said, so those who have some experience or probably good experience with ML or something, so they can probably consider exploring this particular type of problems. And those who are learning more ML and so, I mean, they can consider this problem. Again, there is no foundation. It is finally your choice, which one you want to explore and which one basically you want to learn and so on. So at least in this class, we are giving equal opportunity to perform well in the class by allowing you to select any problems, right? So again, how it is going to evaluate it. So for the research-oriented outcome, so I mean, ideally or probably preferably, I mean, the amount of work that you do, it should be ready for publication. If not fully, at least if you want, again, it's not compulsion. you can basically try put probably more efforts on the particular course project that you're doing and get it to some publication level and publish to some good conference or journals. And especially this is very much evident from the past courses I have taught. And most of, in fact, I would say that many of the course projects have reached to this level, and after a little bit more work, they have been published to good places. So those who want to work on the engineering based project, so in that case, it should be tangible. When I say the tangible, it should be something, some kind of working prototype that can be demonstrated, that can be something, can be the people can play around, right? As I said in the earlier class as well. So in this case, it's fine if you don't have any tangible or prototype system where basically people can play, because it's more on the research side. But if you are going to focus on the engineering side, we expect you to basically provide a working system where the people can play around the system, give their own input, and look at how your system is responding to that. Is the difference between the research-based and the engineering-based project clear to you? Any questions here? Anyone? Prakriti?
No issue, sir. I understand that.
Okay, great. Anyone else? Pragya, Drishti, Dharmendra?
Sir, understood.
Okay, great. So how the work for the class? So I've tried to make it more formalized, and whatever the discussion we had in the last class, I've tried to document it here. So for the midterm, I have reduced to from 22 to 20, because some of you have been asked to somehow, can we increase the mid project review or something, and what can be done? So from 22, I have taken 2 marks from here and just added 2 marks for the project proposal. So in the project proposal, so we expect you to at least write some report and literature review. It's more kind of, we expect you to at least understand the problem, right? Again, so this is true for any kind of project, whether it's a research-based or engineering-based, you'll have to basically come up with some kind of report, right? Like, okay, so what you are going to build or what problem you are going to solve. When I say the literature review, you will have to study what has been done before. Suppose if you're building any engineering based system, then you will have to suggest, okay, so is there any such system exist or not, right? And if it exists, or probably if there is some work is already published, then what is the limitation of those? At least part of the project proposal, we want you to fully understand the problem at least. If not the solution, then at least the problem and the challenges or the issues with the problem that you are going to work. So that's why I taken 2 marks from the midterm to the here. Is it fine with everyone, or anyone has any issue with this? Anyone has any issue with this?
Sir, so assignment is 12 marks and project is 30.
I'm coming to assignment, so please just.
No, there were 2 tabs for assignment and project, that is all.
Where is assignment in the project? Okay, that's a typo. Just keep it project. So let me, thanks for highlighting this. Let me correct this. So this is just an assignment. And yeah, so it happens when you do copy paste, right? And I'm going to warn you as well, when you are going to do the copy paste in your project, so please don't do so. Otherwise you'll see this kind of issues. Okay, wait a second. Is it fine now?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you please highlight what we need to present for week 6 and then for week 10? Like,
yeah, I'm coming to that. Right now I'm just asking. So so it's fine, right? I mean, if we are going to just earlier, this part we have discussed, we are not going to grade, but some of you have asked me how we can increase the little bit. So that's why I just added 2 marks for this. In fact, this will also help you to start project early and fully understand the problem. So I'm coming to more details, what I'm expecting in this. I'm coming to that. So sir, apart from yeah, Dharmil.
All the assignments are in the group, na?
Yeah. So now, many of you. So I have discussed my TAs as well, and so we come to the conclusion. Let's make all the programming assignment as a group assignment, because we already have the midterm and the interim as a individual evaluation and so, right? And even the quizzes. So let's make the assignment and the project as a group evaluation. So that's why we have made three programming assignments that would be group. And in order to make it more individual basis, so what we have discussed, so in each individual assignment, there will be three subparts or three to at least more than one subparts. Two, three, whatever. So it is, I leave it up to the group how they are going to evaluate, how they are going to complete it. So they may divide among the groups based on their convenience and so on. Is it fine? And for the programming assignment, we'll have 1 to 2 weeks deadline, depends on the how much work it is. And it will be group assignment, and there will be 4 marks for all three groups assignments. And we are expecting to release the first group assignment in the next week. And the next will be probably just before the mid-sem, and probably one somewhere much after the mid-sem.
Right. Sir, the assignment group and the project group will be same?
Yes. Both. I mean, once your group is fixed, you're not going to change it, right? So you have to work in the, so it's more like Indian marriage, right? Once you get married, I mean, yeah, you cannot divorce. So anyways, I'm just kidding. So regarding the project, so week 6, so you need to present the project proposal just to emphasize and probably encourage you to fully understand the problem. Week 10, so mid project review, and that would be a 4 marks. So let me go into more details what we are expecting. And finally, the final project, that is towards the end of the course, and that will be 24 marks. So let me go to the more details. So this is the project timeline. So we are expecting to complete the group formation by 21st Jan. So I believe we are on time. Most of the groups are formed. So those who haven't formed the group, hopefully in the next 2 days, they will be able to. For the project topic selection, so you have time 20-28. So once the group is formed, some of you in fact already have finalized their project topic. So I request you to basically choose a topic which is not taken by others. So that's why I shared this particular sheet with you, so that you can see what others are taking, because we don't want two groups to work exactly on the same problem, right? If there are any doubts, please discuss with the TAs or me or both, how you can basically make your problem different from others if already taken, right? So you cannot take exactly the same problem which others groups are taking. Am I clear here? Okay, so regarding the project proposal, so as I said, that will be just 2 marks, and that will be due on the 16th February. So we expect you to at least do problem formulation, clearly mention and define what problem you are going to work on, what is the research problem or the engineering problem you are going to work on, what is the need of solving that problem, and once we are discussing the need, I mean, you also have to highlight what are the works are already exist which have around that problem. Like if it is a research-based paper project, I mean, what are the research paper has been published? Simply just go through, at least go through their abstract and introduction, at least if it is not possible for you to go for the full paper, so that at least you can understand which papers are important, and then which paper attracts you, you can go into more details. Similarly, for the engineering-based work, so you also need to look at, okay, so what are the blocks are there? What are the products are there? Or even there might be some papers as well, right? So you'll have to basically do a literature survey, or you can say more a kind of review, what has been done so far, what the problem you are going to solve. And so we are not talking about solution here. We are mainly talking about understanding the problem and understanding the state of the art. Is it clear? The project proposal is the, and we can basically provide more details, what is the exact format you have to follow. that we can provide sometimes later this week or early next week. But overall, I mean, just to provide a brief summary, we are expecting majorly these two things in the project proposal. Is it clear to you? Okay, so I hope it is clear. If not, then just unmute yourself and ask. So regarding mid-project review, I mean, if you see, we are giving you 1 month additional time after the project proposal. So kind of problem formulation literature review you already done in the past. But based on whatever the comment we will provide after evaluating this, we expect you to so update this. So for example, you might have done some literature survey, and we believe, I mean, you missed some of the important work and so on. So in that case, you have to update this literature review. Similarly, the problem formulation that you propose, there might be some issues with that, right? So we, based on our suggestion, you need to update this, right? And after this, I mean, we also expect you to now, at least in the midterm review, I mean, at least try to complete the baseline results. When I say the baseline, at least try to get the baseline simple results, or at least if you are building engineering system, at least your system should be able to be in position to at least help us to try something. If not a fully functional, at least try something, or at least some based on the given constraint, we can try your system and see how it is working. So that is about the baseline system. So by midterm project review, we expect you to at least complete the baseline results or system. And regarding the proposed method solutions or the whatever the features you are adding to the system, at least you should be clear what you are aiming. If you are not able to fully complete, I mean, in that case, I mean, that's fine. But you will have to tell us what you have done and what you still plans to complete, right? So this will basically clears your, at least our expectation as well, where you are in terms of mid-project review. Yeah, any questions here?
So these review will be in form of a PPT presentation or some report kind of thing?
So the project proposal and the mid-project review will be in the form of report. Final project will be in terms of presentation. So these two will be more on, you can say, the report that you're submitting and the based on the discussion that we'll be having, not a presentation. Or probably if presentation, whenever we do the discussion, it's kind of informal presentation you can think of. So it's more not in front of whole class. Mainly it's a one-to-one basis or something. Group to one, group to TA or group to instructor basis. Okay. But this will be, I mean, yeah. So this will be more in front of class. So in terms of final project, so that is due somewhere in the end of half semester. So now we expect you to basically complete everything. So that include final report, code base, data set, model checkpoints, whatever that, or if you have the system, then the probably working system, deployed, results, evaluation, and with the proper documentation. Is it clear to you? I mean, what we are expecting in the three phases of the project, what is in project proposal, what is in mid project review, and what is in the final project?
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, in the last slide, it was also written that only the command line won't do. So, sir, are we expecting some web kind of interface?
Some kind of web interface for engineering-based project.
Okay, sir.
Some kind of web-based interface or application, whatever you are comfortable with.
So will the design and all for that also affect, or just will only be checking the background?
No, we will not be bothering much on the UI or designing of that part, because here main aim is to build IR system.
Okay, sir, got it.
Yeah, but always it's better to show good thing, right? Because that will again have some impact, right? Some impact on presentation, because it may not have direct impact on the evaluation, but it may have impact on, you can say, when you're doing the presentation, because that is part of your presentation, and presentation also carries some.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other questions here? Nishkarsh is done. Anyone else?
So for research oriented project, would the collab work, or we have to build a UI also for research based? So
for research based system, I mean the collab works as command line things are systems are.
Okay.
Right. Because that's why we want to keep enough work for both sides so that you don't feel which one is easier. Because if you're focusing much on research, we don't want to bother much with the UI and probably other stuff.
Hello.
Simply those who are building the system, we are not bothering much on the research side.
Hello.
Yeah, Kapil.
Yes, sir. Regarding sir research projects. Mm-hmm. So, sir, I guess a research project will also include some bit of a like implementation part.
Yeah, it will. It will. Research means not just
Python coding and everything.
Yeah, of course, it will all include the coding, right? I mean, when I say the research-based,
yes,
of course, you'll be doing coding, you'll be building models, but we are not expecting you to build UI for that model.
So UI is not in the implementation part. Regarding rest, I think everything will be there, like
except
the UI.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Again, I mean, if you're for research project as well, if you want to build UI, I'm not going to stop you. But this is something, I mean, we are not forcing you to do.
Yes.
Okay. Any other questions?
So regarding the research-based project, I have a question.
Yeah, Disha.
So like if we are implementing a research paper, mm-hmm. so in that we have to add some novelty, right?
So the thing is, I understand it's a course project. If you are not able to probably come up with some very novel thing, that is fine. But at least try. I mean, the main aim is to encourage you to try something, right? And here, I mean, it's not like a conference where basically we say, okay, so you have not beaten the state of the art. So whatever the proposed method you have proposed is not beating the state of the art. So we will give you 0 marks. It's not like that, right? It's more kind of, okay, so if you have performed better than state of the art, that's good. I mean, you may get more reward. And those who are not able to, that's fine. I mean, they will also get rewards, but probably not as much as compared to the team who has probably done very, very good work in terms of getting better than state of the art. So here, at least we want you and probably encourage you to try at least. Try at least different thing that basically can help you because here basically we also want you to encourage you because most of you are master's student and many of you are going for higher studies and so, right? So until you won't try, I mean, this research thing, I mean, you won't be able to learn. Again, it's not mandatory. It is up to you which direction you want to go ahead, whether it's a research based or engineering based, choice is yours. But I will try my best to, in fact, with all the TAs we have, to encourage you to explore any topic you want, and we will help you with best of our abilities, be it a research based, be it like engineering based. We will be very happy in the different discussion to encourage you and probably suggest you, okay, so this is something you can try. And you also have to help us by doing more literature survey, doing basically coming with different ideas, and we can help you with finalizing the feasibility of that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Any other question from anyone?
Excuse me, sir. Sir, just a clarification regarding the assignment. So for the assignment, we'll be evaluated as a group or based on the question we have done individually?
No. So that will be evaluated based on the group.
Okay, sir.
And how I'm going to evaluate group? So I told you earlier, I'm going to do anonymous peer review. So if there is a good bonding between group, I mean, everyone is going to get same marks. If your group is saying, okay, so out of these five groups, I mean, this particular person is not doing at all. In that case, firstly, we will check with the person, we'll do the clarification. And after that, if we convince that the person has not contributed to the project, we are not going to give equal mark as a team. Am I clear?
Yeah, okay, sir.
Anyone else? Any other questions you have?
Sir, do we need to host the system for engineering problem, or we can host it locally?
No, you need to host it. I mean, we can provide you the ways to. Probably, I mean, yeah, so whole the backend thing will be working with our server. We will provide you space on the server, so don't worry about computational and the space requirement. At least in terms of UI, something you can send a request to our server, right? Whether wherever you host it. So for example, just hosting on Heroku, right? Heroku, whatever.
Yes, sir.
Right? So yeah, we will provide you, I mean, with that help. I mean, all the, so especially to the, and the people who will be focusing on the research-based project, they need both computational and the space requirement, right? We'll be very happy to provide everything. So here, I mean, from our side, we'll be very happy to provide you whatever you need. And we only want you to basically sincerely work on the project. And end of the day, I mean, yeah, so it is up to you where you want to take your project, whether it's just a normal project, just like you may have done in the past, or probably you may have done good work as well in the past as well. Or probably you want to take it further and something you want to remember. So for example, I mean, in the last year, I taught a course of designing of interactive system. Some of the people have come up with very interesting problem, and now they are also exploring the possibility of filing patent and probably going for a startup. For example, I can give you an example. One of my students, one group of students, basically they come up with games for the blind. Can anyone comment what kind of games you can build for blind people?
Something so sound related.
Something sound related, okay. So for example, if you're playing in a class, there is a lot of noise. I mean, in that case, do you think, I mean, such kind of games will be helpful or useful?
Sir, Scrabble.
Hello? Sorry?
Scrabble.
Okay, what you will do with that?
Sir, you know, blind people can recognize Braille. So the blocks can contain letters based on Braille, so they can play Scrabble as well.
So yeah, that's fine. But one of the issue with this kind of thing, the people having disability, when you make them feel like, yeah, you are different, I mean, probably, I mean, that is fine. But yeah, so they may not feel that much comfortable, especially if they are want to have fun. So can you think of something else so that
whether there can be the remotes, like having the impressions, like whether it is written A, so A is having an impression so that they can recognize with their finger movements and all.
Mm-hmm. Okay, nice effort. Anyone else?
They can use hand gestures to play.
Hand gesture. Okay, that's also nice. So what we have done in that project? So we have come up with a haptic based game, just like you can say egg catcher game, right? Or probably any multiplayer game or something where you are basically playing with each other, right? So for example, in that case, we have built a system. Right now I don't have console here, but you can check. Or if you want, let me show you. Did I show that demo here in the class? I believe not.
I don't think.
So you can see, I mean, some options are here, especially in our case. Okay. Yeah, so this is the one. So let me, I think I haven't shared the audio of the system. Let me stop sharing and share it again. So I hope you can see the video, right?
Presenting Haptek, a new and innovative gaming console made for the visually impaired. It consists on its surface of 4x7 grid made up of individual vibrational motors and an LED matrix. Simply connect your phone to the console. Place your hand on the grid and start playing. All you need to do is feel for the objects of the game and play using your phone. Just swipe left or right in the middle and lower portions of the screen. The curved surface of the console provides ease of use and comfort to the player. Haptek aims to give its player a wholesome gaming experience, where you will not just hear the game, but feel it too.
This is another system that we have built. So I'm sure, I mean, the course project that I have shown, both course project are in the process of, you can say, startup. Both course project has been published to the top places. So it's more, I mean, I just wanted to show this, like, if you are willing to work, I'm ready. And my team is basically willing to help you throughout the process. If you just want to finish, I mean, you are perfectly fine. I mean, we don't have an issue with that. So these both system I've shown is part of designing of interactive system, not much related with the IR. So in this case, IR, we have probably different needs. So for example, we have discussed different course projects, right? So for some course project that you can see here, so many of them are very interesting, right? So highlight review analysis tool, news article categorization. I mean, just reading the random stuff, you need to go read and probably yes, for example, Codify, code search engine. Are you aware of any code search engine, by the way? Anyone? Or did you feel requirement of having such code search based engine? Because you often you have to write some codes and you want to use existing tool, right? Existing codes. Are you aware of any such code search based engine? Anyone?
No, sir. We just make use of Stack Overflow or something.
Yes.
How many of you are aware of, by the way, the papers with code.com? So though it's not code search engine, but something similar you can think of building using that. So for example, how many of you are aware of this particular website, papers with code.com?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So you can see, I mean, so this particular website, the best part, whatever the paper has been listed here, it is not only paper and often the open source and the just any engineering based project as well. Whatever the work has been mentioned here, I mean, all have their corresponding code, right? So you may, can you think of, I mean, what can be done again? So if someone want to explore this, they can try. Okay. Okay. So if you look at more, so this is a website I want you to quickly have a look at, because some of the stuff I'm going to show has, I hope you can hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
So some of the website that, yeah. Is my screen stop sharing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this particular website you can have a look at. That is again on information retrieval at UIUC. And UIC is one of the best place for any NLP research. I mean, at least in the world. I mean, it's a dream place for many people. So, yeah, so I was fortunate to basically work with one of the professor here during my postdoc, but yeah, who was working at Singapore Management University. And yeah, so it has basically listed down, I mean, very, very nicely, many important topics and the points that you need to follow. For example, what is the general steps? I mean, usually you pick a topic or probably team related work, write a proposal, what to work on the proposal and so on, right? So we will be soon coming with the similar thing and probably provide you more rubric. Some of them I have highlighted and rest probably you can have a look at. They have also mentioned some of the sample projects. You can also take any sample project from here. In fact, some of the sample project from here, I guess listed in the list I've shared, right? So that you can see here. So what if you want to find a friend? What if you want to do some kind of highlight, a review analysis tool or check the news or something? Right, so this is something, I mean, again, so some of the example that you have seen. So let me get back to the presentation. Yeah, so this is what I'm highlighting mainly. So probably we have diverted. So yeah, so you are very much encouraged to give your best and I will be very happy to help you if you want to take it further. If not, that is perfectly fine. And yeah. Regarding the rubric for the project, so for the project proposal, as I mentioned, 2 marks, one marks for the problem formulation, how well you articulated the problems formulation and probably the limitations. And literature review, I mean, how well you have articulated, find out different related work related to the problem that you're working on and what are the issues with that and so, right? So that is mainly for the project proposal. For the mid project review,
sir,
this
will be a 4 marks, na?
No, project. The project proposal is 2 marks. Mid project review is of 4 marks. Here, right? So project proposal is 2 marks. Mid project proposal is 4 marks. And final project is 24. Is it clear?
You said that, na? Ki, midterm will be deducted. 2 marks.
Midterm.
Yeah. This is
midterm examination. Earlier it was 22. I have taken these 2 marks to the project proposal.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So the 2 marks will be for the project proposal, midterm project review. So we have 4 marks as before. So updated formulation, because you may come up with something, we provide some comments, we want you to update this. So 0.5 marks each for these. Baseline results, so by this, we expect you to at least come up with a basic system or probably reproduce the result or something like that. So that is 2 marks for that. And 1 marks for proposed methods, features in your system. Again, so it's fine if you're not able to complete fully, but try to complete at least some of them. And finally, the final project, that is of 24 marks. So we will provide you the different templates and probably the guideline how you want to submit. Because if we ask you to submit the paper in ACM LaTeX template, we'll provide you the template, then we expect you to complete your report and that, right? Rather than you just come up with say Word file or something else. We don't want. We want everyone to follow the same template. These are small things, but these are very, very important things. Similarly, the structure, right? We ask you to specifically create a folder for project, create a subfolder for code, subfolder for something, right? So simply follow that. These are very small thing, but these are very important thing. If you're going to work with some big organization later on, it's very, very important to do the thing structured way. Otherwise, you know, right? In information retrieval, if the query is unstructured, you're not going to get as good as result as compared to the structured query and the results, right? So that's why, I mean, just follow this thing, right? If you do in more structured way, we are going to retrieve better results, better marks. Otherwise, we may not end up with a good one. So we expect you to provide a detailed readme or something. So for example, you have some code base or something, right? Or you have some system. if this system has been given to someone, if this system has been given to someone, how they can use it, right? Because often whatever you write is not feasible for anyone else to follow it unless it is very, very self-intuitive. And again, no one is very perfect in that. So it's better create a README. So again, this encourage you. And this is again a very, very important aspect of any system that you do. So that's why we want you to create a detailed README and to easily follow, access, or use your system. So again, very minimal mark for this, but these are very small things that you can easily, if you follow, get it. We want you to follow version control system. You can simply follow GitHub or something, right? The reason being, we want you to use version control system for several reasons. In the past, I have seen the people basically come up and say, sir, my laptop has broken, my this had happened and that happened. And that's why, I mean, yeah, so we lost the code and we are not able to do some things, please help me. I cannot help, right? It's better way simply follow the version control system. That is the reason one. Second reason, if you're going to either work with industry or even with academia, like even my lab, everyone is using the version control system to maintain their code base or something. Because in this way, you keep track of what is happening and you never lose the things. And also, I mean, it gives you basically the flexibility to go back and probably, if you had done something wrong, and go back and probably get back to the previous system, right? So that's why we strongly encourage to follow this. Again, if you don't follow, I mean, we don't have an issue, we just cut the mark. Another reason I want to highlight why we want to do this, because based on my experience, this will also help you to stop copying exactly the existing code. And because if you're going to copy exactly the code, we also want to see how we have changed over the time, right? And that is the thing, something we encourage you to basically do. I mean, it is very much important and useful for you, and it's for your sake, not for mine. And I hope this is fine with you. Any comment for the first 3 points?
Sir, like when we use GitHub over the Dalarna project, should we like create a private repo? Or,
yeah, that's fine. Create a private repo, add your corresponding TA as a.
Okay, thank you.
Right? Because so it's kind of, for example, there are 5 people. And you can just add your TA.
Yes.
Okay. Any other comments, questions?
Sir, the account should be of like IIIT mail, or can be personal email? And
no, it could be personal, whatever you are already using. I don't want to force you on that part, right? If you already have some GitHub account with your personal email ID. In fact, by the way, you can add your IIIT email IDs as well, right? You can link both accounts.
Yes, sir, we can add it like a secondary email. Yeah.
Yes, if you already have the email ID, why don't you add it? Because this will also help you to basically give additional freedom, right? Because if you're going to work with Overleaf, right? For example, for the LaTeX, your IIIT will give you the premium access as compared to your personal email ID. So you may start using, get the benefit of what you're already getting. And even from IIIT email ID, I'm not sure, but you can get probably some academic benefit or something. I'm not sure, because at least for my lab, I mean, we are able to get a huge space and probably other additional benefit being academic organization, and probably something you may get, but again, you'll have to check. Anything else? Okay.
Sir, regarding the UI for engineering project, regarding the UI part, it can be any technology like ASP, JSP, PHP.
Yeah. Right. We don't want to stop you. You are free to choose anything. I mean, we are only want to see and try the system. We don't bother whether you have used whatever in the background.
Thank you.
Okay. So for the project report, whatever the report that you will be building, so that carries 5 marks. We will provide more details what would be the exact rubric for that. But for time being, you can just take this thing, like project report would be 5 marks. So basically, it will also include all the how you have basically articulated and written down all the contribution you have done, and it also include the problem formulation, literature review. And in a way, if you see, I mean, many things are what you're doing here, the previous two steps will help you significantly to get good marks in that. So for example, whatever you have done is going to help you again here. And if you're whatever you have done is going to help you here in again the final project. So kind of, if you simply follow, I mean, these process, you will get easily get good marks, irrespective of you, whether you have good background in NLP or machine learning or not. We really appreciate efforts. We really appreciate efforts. If you're putting efforts and trying to achieve the things, we will help you throughout the process. So contribution. So yeah, so what new contribution that you are adding? So that is, you have to look at. So again, so this also includes reproduction of the results from the existing code base and everything. So we will appreciate all these efforts here. And also we expect you what the new thing you are doing. So that is in terms of feature, that is in terms of adding some research component and so on. Evaluation, you can see it's a 5 marks, one of the major component of whole, because we don't just want you to complete the system. We don't just want to propose your system. Ideally, you should also appreciate that evaluation is very important aspect of any product. Again, so for engineering-based system, different kind of evaluation could be. So for research-based system, different evaluation metric is there, you can use that, right? So end of the day, we want to see how evaluation you have done. I mean, how you have checked the validity, efficiency, accuracy of your system. Whether it's a performing better than before, if the system already exists, if it is not, then yeah. So what are the, how it is working with corresponding simple baselines that we want you to basically do. And finally, the project presentation that carries 4 marks by end of the project. Any questions here?
Sir, so regarding evaluation, like if we are like proposing a new method, like, and we are including some novelty, like in the way we are training or something, but it does not beat like a recent SOTA method, but it beats some baselines, then would it be okay, or is it like
that will be okay? As I said, I mean, it's not like a conference paper, like we are going to reject your paper or report.
Okay.
You will get marks, but definitely you will not get as much as mark as compared to the other project or group members who have basically beat the state of that, right?
Okay.
Any other questions? Okay, I believe it's no more questions. So let's go next. So form a team that you already done. And this is, I mean, how you can do. I mean, that is something we quickly look at. Literature review. So what we are expecting in the related work. So we basically want you to just simply choose the topic that you will be done by next week. So after that, why it is very important to perform literature review. I hope it is very clear to you. It is very important to aware of whether the problem you would like to tackle has already been solved. If you already know, I mean, that has been solved, so there is no point of reinventing the wheel again, because it was already invented before. What you can do, how you can make the wheel run faster, how you can make the wheel be more robust, how you can make the wheel probably make look better, right? Or how you can basically make the wheel, which is probably less costly as before. So this is something you can need to think about. You need to something probably think about all those goals, and then basically you can propose what you want to solve. So to minimize your efforts, yeah, so as I said before as well, I'm just writing it again. You are encouraged to leverage existing algorithms, toolkits, other useful resources, code and everything. Just you need to give the due acknowledgement from where you are taking, right? So instructor and TS can also help you to check with the related work. I mean, as part of the different reviews that will be happening in between. So feel free to discuss with us, I mean, to finalize your project and so. Any questions here? Okay. So when picking a topic, try to ask following questions. As I said, I mean, some of the details are taken from this slide, this link. I mean, they have very well articulated this. So again, so I don't want to reinvent the wheel again, right? It is, if it is already there, I just try to, so I basically kind of, I've done the literature survey for this and I found this, I'm just showing to you with the due acknowledgement. So, right. So when picking a topic, try to ask yourself the following question. What is exactly, either it's a research problem or normal engineering problem that you want to solve? Will it matter if nobody realizes this problem, right? Of course, right? So you'll have to probably work on a problem which you also think and probably motivate you to work on that. How it is going to help others? What kind of changes could you, your project make to the others? Is there any existing alternatives, right? If so, do you still want to do it? Or what is the new idea or what are the new features that you're going to add? Similarly, what be the major challenges? Because if you're going to solve any problem, there will be challenges, right? So can you think about those challenges? If you think some challenge is something impossible for you, then don't take that project. Probably think of some simpler one. If you think, yeah, you can try, you can explore. I mean, so challenge yourself, no issue. And go and probably take that. So what is the minimal goal to be achieved during this semester? So again, it is up to you. Where you want to take this course project? And how do you plan to demonstrate method to develop and so on? So empirical evaluation, experimentation, demo are required. So if it is a research engineering base, then you need to focus more on the demo. If it is on the research side, it should be more on the empirical experimentation and so on, right? So finally, the project guideline, you are free to choose any project involving IR, data mining or data science. And so you can select any papers, any topic. Some of you, we have already highlighted, you are free to choose from here. You can free to propose anything else. You can also choose any existing paper and extend it, all your choice. You are free to choose publicly available data set code and data. So I already mentioned. So data project team size should not be more than 5 students in a group. I hope it is also clear. Project report should be in the ACM CGIAR LaTeX template. I will provide you the template later on. You can simply follow. So this is something we don't tolerate. I mean, because some of the course project that we have highlighted, I mean, most of the course project probably have already done by your seniors or probably other students in the, right? You cannot simply take this, right? You cannot simply take it. I mean, you are definitely take help from that and think of what has been done before and how you can, because we already have all the reports, right? We are going to do the matching. If we found that you are exactly submitting the same report by just changing the name, right? Of course, I mean, you are going to get 0 marks. So please avoid that. Don't do that. Not avoid, just don't do that, right? So you are free to take help of the existing resources, give proper acknowledgement, and just extend it from where it has been exist, right? So please make sure that. Any questions here before we end the project discussion? So regarding writing proposal, you can just simply look at, we'll provide more details, work on the project. So that's a very simple thing. Yeah, so any questions before we end the project discussion topic? Any questions?
Is it the case that if we choose an engineering project, we will be getting less marks as compared to those?
No. No, not at all, right? Why? I told you, right? So there will be a different evaluation for different track, right? If it is research based, as I said, right? We focus more on the empirical experimentation. If it is engineering, we focus on the demo and the how it works. So end of the day, I mean, rubric for both are different, right? Rubric for both are different, but both carry 20-30 marks itself only, right? I mean, if you see, I mean, it's the same. Only thing which is going to change here, I mean, for research-based project, we are going to have different evaluation. For demo-based system, we are going to have different evaluation. Rest are same, right? And even, I mean, in my previous courses and the previous course project, I mean, yeah, so both basically got good marks. I mean, in fact, I would say very comparable marks, because it depends on how much efforts and what finally you able to produce. Any other questions? Anyone? Okay.
Hello.
Yes. Who's there?
Sir, I'm Shivank.
Yeah, please go ahead.
So, sir, in engineering-based project, what other things we have to do apart from taking some already existing solution to a problem? Should we need to improve it to some more extent in this engineering-based project? Or
So, for example, right? For example, if you are going to build a retrieval system, right? So, I would like to see, right? If some retrieval system is already exist, how does it perform? And so, because there are two parts, right? One is the contribution. If one thing, I mean, you also build something similar. So that's good. I mean, if you have added some new feature. The next part is the evaluation. As I said, I want to see how good your system is working, right? So that is come under the evaluation. If some system is already exist, can you do some kind of comparison? Like for example, your proposed retrieval system giving the correct result at the third position, and the previous was probably giving at fifth position, right? Or probably, I mean, in your case, you made this particular system basically take any kind of input. So for example, whether it's a small image, big image, or any kind of image. So again, I mean, regarding the rubric and how we are going to evaluate, the engineering-based project, how we are going to evaluate the research-based project, we'll be providing in more details in the coming classes.
So can I say the engineering-based project will more focus on the how we improve the implementation, like how we improve the already existing model in terms of implementation rather than novelty in making some new solution to a problem?
No. Novelty will, I mean, look, I mean, when you say the novelty, right? If probably existing system provide three features. So for example, it only provides a text-based retrieval. What you have done, you have added the, say, location-based retrieval as well. So it's not only the implementation, right? I mean the improvement in the code, but it's also like, can you add new features to that? That's how we can evaluate, right? Because evaluation can be anything, right? Evaluation can be of many types. So one evaluation in terms of feature. That's why if you look at for engineering based projects, I emphasize on the features. Yes. And probably for research based, we focus on the proposed method. And for engineering based, we focus on the features.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Yes, Ivan. Thanks. Anything else from anyone? So if you look at the different projects here, we can just quickly take this. So for example, just as a use case, if someone work on image-based search engine, right? When you say the image-based search engine, so can anyone tell me, so how you are going to proceed with this? Anyone? I mean, suppose you have to work on this image-based search engine, how you are going to proceed?
So by working on object detection at first. We can basically work on the object detection system, and then
the problem formulation. What the problem that you are willing to solve? So what will be your problem statement here?
Finding similar images. If we input an image to a system, finding similar images to that.
Right. So let me just take this an example and probably tell you what I'm expecting if you are going to take this system as an engineering base. And what I'm expecting, at least if you're going to take as a research base. If you're going to take this system as a, say, research based, right? You can simply use any existing database, data set, right? because there is already some number of database are already here, right? You can use any existing dataset system and see how the different image, their different research-based paper which focusing on image-based search engine or image-based retrieval on this and how it works on that given dataset. So usually in the dataset, you have fixed set of train, validation, and probably test set, right? So we want you to basically choose one problem. So for example, you want to focus on how fast the retrieval is, or probably you choose the problem, how accurate your retrieval is, how relevant your retrieval is. In that case, probably, for example, you can choose evaluation metric like precision recall and something, right? So we will basically, you're evaluating your system, how your proposed method is working on based on the evaluation metric, precision recall and F1 score for on the test set, right? And that test set should be ideally what the people have been using for previous papers, right? That is more on the research side. When if you are going to solve this work on engineering side, in that case, I mean, when I'm trying your system, I'm free to give any input to your system, right? And now I don't want to restrict myself to the only the train, test and other set, right? You should provide me flexibility because the query could be anything, right? So for example, if you're using ImageNet as a, you can say the base for building your image based search engine. I don't want to give, I mean, I may or I may not give an image as an input, which is from ImageNet. So how your system is going to work if I give an image from, say, ImageNet? How your system is going to work when I give an image which is not part of the ImageNet, but still it should give some result, right? Because end of the day, I mean, your system should give me some results. Or either say, I mean, no, I cannot give you this result because due to this, that reason. Am I clear here? I just try to give a vague example, taking one project and how the different aspect you can look at, in the, when you explore the research-based, when you explore the, you can say the engineering-based. For example, if you're working on engineering-based, you can also think of, okay, so current database probably only focusing on the image-based matching. Only comparison of the different images, input image and the database images and so on. So we have added additional thing like by comparing with the metadata as well. So if you just give me metadata as well, or only metadata, based on that, we can retrieve the system. So you can think of, so it's kind of, you extended the functionality, extended the feature of the existing system by searching by location, searching by text, searching by probably or something else. Does it make sense to you? I mean, what could be if you want to explore the research-based project, and what if you want to explore the engineering-based project? Is it fine with everyone?
So, yes. For the research-based projects, the input will be defined previously, like from the fixed data set.
Usually in the research-based project, because we want to quantify, right? And if you want to quantify, if you are going to check on the new data, new input or something, we don't know the ground truth, right? You'll have to manually do a lot of work. I mean, that is not required. Unless you are creating the data set by yourself.
So, sir, while doing the research-based project, then the data set which the input will be given from, is that data set will be given to us also so that we can practice, or we can say...
No, you have to do that. You have to find that as part of your literature survey, right? When you are doing literature survey, suppose you find any paper. So you also need to select a paper based on whether data set is available or not. One possibility, either choose the data set. Another possibility, suppose data set is not publicly available. Can you use other publicly available data set and reproduce the result of this particular paper that you are following on the new data set? So that is kind of, you first try to produce state of the art result on given data set, and then try to improve on that. Is it fine?
Yes, sir. And for engineering project, the input can be anything.
Yeah, engineering project, for example, I've just given, right? I don't want to restrict, because I want you to build engineering project system, right? So where it should, it should be in work for any input, right? I mean, suppose it's an image-based search engine. I mean, I don't only want to give the image which is from your data set. I also want to give an, so your system should have capability to deal with such kind of inputs.
Sir, then the engineering project seems a little harder than the research, because in a research project, because for the research project, the data set or the input is defined. And
That's basically, that's what I'm saying. I mean, I don't want to make anyone simpler, or you can say very complex. If you see, there is a different trade-off, right? If you're not, for engineering-based project, if you're not spending much time on the research aspect, I mean, how you can improve the system. In that case, I mean, I want you to focus on, okay, so how you can extend the capability of the system, right? End of the day, I mean, in fact, if you see, honestly, it's not much work, because your existing system already knows how to, for a given, you basically, for example, if we're talking about image-based search engine, right? You have the image, you compute its representation and compare with the different document you have in the database. So only thing in the engineering-based project will be you need to additionally do simply for the way you are getting the representation from your, whatever the image that you have in the data set, you need to compute the representation for the new image, right? So it's kind of a little bit pre-processing will be added at the cost of less research.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Any other questions?
So, sir, while using the pre-processing unit or code, then it won't fall under the plagiarism thing.
I said, right?
Yeah.
You are free to use anything, just provide the acknowledgement.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, sir. Yes.
Any other questions? Okay, if not, then thank you so much, everyone. I believe, I mean, yeah, so we do not have much time now to go for the lecture slide today. But I believe today's class is more informative and provided in-depth details about the different project that we'll be doing. Right? Any other question before we conclude
today? Sir.
Okay, great, Rahul.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you everyone, and Hello. Feel free to let us know if you have any questions regarding the tutorial, or you can say the doubt clearing session. We'll be sharing more details regarding the helping session for NLP and ML related stuff. We will also be sharing survey, and we'll set up a meeting accordingly. Okay, so see you day after tomorrow then. Thanks everyone.
Hello.
Yeah.
No, sir, this is Indranil this side. I just want to ask something. If you don't mind, can you please give one more example of any of the projects and just say, how can I approach that problem in the research way?
Indranil, I'm sorry. Actually, I need to quickly leave for another meeting.
Okay, it's fine, sir.
So I'm sorry. Actually, that's why I don't want to probably. Yeah, but what we can do, we can take it offline. Probably you can discuss with TAs. If it is not resolved, we can set up a meeting and discuss.
Yeah, sure, sir. Sure.
Or probably in the day after tomorrow, we can take up another example in the class and discuss.
Okay, sir. No problem. Have a good day.
Okay, then. Thanks, everyone. Bye.